Hello, everybody, and welcome back to Boat Club. Down here at the Boat Club docks, we're getting ready to set sail for another half an hour-ish of improvised comedy. And what does improv mean? It means it's all made up on the spot, a baby. And hey, I hear you out there crying out like those same babies who were asking me what improv means. Just like, oh no, that sounds hard. I couldn't do that on my own. Well, luckily, I'm not on my own. I've got with me, as always, the two boys who you want to hear make some noise. It's Johnny Yachtsville, a.k.a. John. Hi, John.
Hey. Happy to be here.
And, of course, Tommy Tugboat, a.k.a. Tom. Hi, Tom.
Captain, the iron sharpens the iron, Sensei.
And me, Joe. So today, we're down here at the docks as per normal, but hey, is that a projector that's been set up down here at the Boat Club docks?
What's it doing?
Is that a screen that projector is pointing at? I think it might be a movie night here at Boat Club.
Clip Ooh. Show.
No, wow. We're not doing
no.
Hey guys, remember when?
That's for the 100th episode.
The celebration of a clip show. Great.
And no one will watch it.
Not even John.
Not even me.
I'll watch it.
Oh.
We said no one.
Shit.
We're stopping you from watching it.
Or is Joe actually just really destroying me there, calling me no one?
Oh. Work it out for yourself.
Oh, God.
It could go both ways.
Shit.
So it is movie night, which means we're going to do the movie format, which, John, do you want to explain a little bit for the fine folk at home, a.k.a. you, just to find out later whether you explained it well?
I'm not going to explain it. I'm just going to say we're going to do a movie and everything is going to be improvised, but it's going to be a movie that you've probably never seen before.
And the way we're going to do this is, because we like to play by our own rules here, we have from an online randomized genre generator and a random word generator collected a suggestion for a genre and a word. We're going to put those together and we're going to make a film from it. And boys, you ready to find out what we're going to be doing today?
Oh, I am.
I am too.
Well,
I can tell you that I really wish I'd planned this, but I didn't. Your randomized genre is romance.
Oh.
And your random word is divorce.
Oh, great. Okay.
Great. And the way this is going to go is, as always, we will count down together, 3, 2, 1, and together say Boat Club. From there, the show will keep going till one or possibly all of us say, and that's the show. But don't leave then, because as always, the bit to stick around for is the plugs.
Great. I can't wait.
So,
in fact, skip to this time now if you want to skip past all of that.
Put a timestamp on there for the plugs.
Yeah.
Hello. Hey, guys, click here for the end of the video. You can
click here for the end. Just
someone will come.
Click it and find out.
It will be peaceful.
And with that, are you ready to present our divorce romance?
Oh, God, okay, yeah.
All right, in that case, in 3, 2, 1,
Boat Club.
All right, we see a church, and as we move into the church, you see that it's full of people waiting, and the groom is waiting at the end of there. He's in a nice kind of like white suit. And the bride's walking down the aisle in her like beautiful flowing dress. There's kind of some kind of totally non-copyright romantic music playing as she walks down the aisle. And yet the priest opens his wedding book of priest stuff.
Well, guys, the day is here.
Yeah.
And according to the wedding book, apparently I'm supposed to put two rings on you both.
Wait, sorry. Hi, sorry. Gerald, the groom.
Yes.
Quick question.
What is it, hun?
Are you meant to put two rings on each of us?
No. It's one each.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was just thinking because we've only got two rings. Have we done a full?
Okay, right.
So that's
fine.
Good.
Don't be
that's
weird about good. It. Don't be weird about it.
It's Do you fine. Mind if I check the wedding book for that?
Yeah. Okay, fine. Yes.
No, it looks fine. And one ring each. Gerald.
Hi, yeah.
Gerald.
Hi, yeah. Good to see you.
Both Gerald.
Yeah.
We met at a club for Gerald's.
Yeah.
I'm honored to have these two wonderful people here for marriage. Please hold hands. Gerald.
Yeah?
I'll point to you and I'll say Gerald A.
To me?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. But my surname's Gerald A.
Okay, well.
Why do you think it's so complicated? All right. Happiest day.
This is most peculiar for possibly the best day of your lives. Keep stop starting. There's been a lot.
It's fine. Let's just come on. This is the happiest day. It's the happiest day. Let's just get on with it. Let's just commit our lives to each other.
Okay.
Let's just do this. Come on, it's fine.
It's just been a very stressful day with so many Geralds running around.
Yes, I know.
Gerald, hey. Don't worry.
Thank you, Gerald.
No, sorry, I was talking to my best man, Gerald.
We cut away, and we zoom into a fancy New York apartment. And then we see the tagline at the bottom, some text that says 3 years later. And Gerald A., Tom's character, is sitting in his apartment with his best friend and roommate.
So we never got, why did you take his surname?
Because I just thought that A would be a good surname. A-Y-E. I thought it would be fine.
Well, do they just be like, hey?
Yes, that's exactly what I thought, yeah. And now I'm getting through this. I don't know, you know, it's just been so hard. And like, thank you for putting me up here. I really appreciate it. You know, things are tough at the moment. And
it's no problem. Gerald's casa is Gerald's casa.
Thank you, Gerald. Yes, I mean, I really appreciate it. See, the thing is, I just feel like, you know what, Gerald, I think I just need a change. I think I just need to spend some... I never thought I'd say this, but I think I just need to spend some time away from Gerald. Not you, Gerald, but my husband, Gerald.
I've said this all along. You know what your problem was you rushed into this with someone You rushed into this with someone who, yeah, that was where my sentence was ending. Clearly,
sorry. I'm just sorry. Just carry on. Yeah, I'm just all
you
over the place at the
you,
moment.
You and Gerald, you're a lot alike. That's the problem.
Yeah,
opposites attract. You should be with someone who's different enough to you. Who you can really see what makes you good in them. Not by seeing you in them.
You know what, Gerald? I think you're right. You know what? This divorce is going. It's going through, and I think that once it goes through, you know, I'm gonna really grab life by the horns, and you know, really, you know, find someone that just makes me feel like a better version of me. But first, I think, you know, I just need to get this through. I mean, I'm meeting up with the lawyer later today, and I know they seem pretty good, and hopefully they'll be.
I just want to check. You didn't also meet this lawyer at the Gerald Club, did you?
Well, they prefer to be called Jerry. Okay. Okay. Right. Thanks for the coffee. Thanks for the coffee, Gerald. I'll see you later on. I'll see you around. Okay.
Suddenly, we see at a different, faintly, we see a coffee shop, and we see other Gerald A. there, sat with the best man, Gerald, from the wedding. So what do you think? I'm thinking of asking Gerald to renew our vows.
Aren't you guys having a rough time at the moment?
Yeah, and I really think this could be the thing that makes it. And I think Gerald wants it as well, because he asked for us to meet at our special place tonight, the TGI Fridays. You know, that TGI Fridays.
In Times Square?
Yeah, the Times Square TGI Fridays.
The one that's always filled with children.
What? Because I don't know if you remember. Of course you remember, because you were there playing the waiter. When we did that whole thing of me being like, oh no, I'm choking on something in this baked potato skin.
Yeah, Gerald,
and then
listen.
I spat out the ring onto Gerald's hand.
Gerald,
I want to do that again.
Gerald, it just kind of feels like this entire relationship has been like a farce. I mean, me pretending to be a waiter, this wedding filled with other Gerald's. Met Gerald at GeraldCon, and honestly, everybody there was called Gerald, and it was just so confusing. The only person that wasn't called Gerald was the priest.
Yeah, and even he was called Harold, but pronounced it with a weird E kind of sound.
It was so strange. And now that you guys are on a, you know, you're on shaky terms, Gerald, your husband is now staying over at his friend's house.
Because they're clearly planning something special for our 1 year anniversary as well.
I don't know, Gerald.
And I've got to plan something more special.
Okay, look, I'm your best friend, and I want this to work out, but I just don't think it's going to work. I'm sorry. I'm being super...
I hear you. I got to go bigger.
No, go on. Yeah,
we cut to lawyer's office, and you can see there's sort of a whole wall of books in the background, a large sort of oak desk with a leather sort of top, which sort of has a nice bit of embroidery on it. And you see the lawyer, Jerry, there. And Gerald is just sort of, is Gerald, my character, is sat there.
All right. So I've been reviewing your paperwork here, and looks like essentially your partner. Sorry, which of you is Gerald A?
Both of us.
Ah. Right. So the problem is, under New York law, legally speaking, if you both have the same name, you count as one person and you can't divorce yourself.
What?
You heard me. So what you're going to need to do is... you're going to need to get a name change, but also you're going to need your husband to sign off on this, because otherwise it would be like half of you signing off on it.
Sorry, so let me just get this straight.
Listen, buddy, I didn't go to Rikers University for one semester in order to obtain this certificate printing kit in order to get my law degree for you to question me.
So hang on, wait. You're telling me that I have to change my name?
Yep.
Are you even like a registered? You just said that you've got a printing kit. What is this? What is this? Is like, well, this is a Jerry.
I've been reviewing your finances. You can't afford a proper lawyer, so instead you get me.
So I have to. What am I going to change my name to? I'm so Gerald, you know. That's just me. Everyone's like, "Oh, here comes Gerald," and it's like, "That's me. That's who I am." There's not a lot of us left.
Have you thought of Gerald?
Oh, that's not Gerald.
All right. Hey, look. I know a guy down in Chinatown, great with names. Go see him. He'll get you sorted out with a beautiful name.
We cut to the other side of the city. And we see the airport, and we see coming out of the airport is a bumbling young man with a briefcase with a Union Jack on it, and he's got a tie, and on his shirt there is a very clear tag that says, "Hi, my name is Jonathan." It's very clear. It says Jonathan with a J and an O. And there are other people there that don't have the name Gerald.
We also see a person holding up a sign with Jonathan on it, obviously with a driver's cap on.
Are you looking for me? I'm Jonathan.
Jonathan, yes.
Yes.
Welcome to New York.
Oh, you're British too.
Of course.
Oh, you're British. Oh, fantastic. You're jolly good. It's lovely to meet you. Oh goodness, my suitcase. It's just. Oh, I dropped it. Oh. Now all my clothes are everywhere. Oh no, they're in a dark, muddy puddle. Would you mind?
No, Jonathan, of course. It would be my pleasure. This isn't my first Britishman coming to New York, you know.
is it not? Are they normally this clumsy? I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry about this.
Suddenly, Jonathan and his driver both lean down to pick up a pair of his boxes at the same time, and their hands meet.
Oh, no, I'm so sorry.
No, it's frightfully all right. Yes.
I'm so sorry. My boxes and my underwear and my shirt and goodness me, I brought some bananas from the kiosk of the airport. I'm so sorry.
Of course. So, Jonathan, I must ask, you're here for business or pleasure?
I assume you're taking me to my new temp job at the Daily Star. Is that what you're not? The Daily Star, yeah, right? I'm so sorry.
Yes, of course, sir. Please get in the car here.
Oh goodness, which one? I'm so clumsy. I don't know which car to get in.
This one here, sir. A black cab. As we see the black cab, we hear. Ah, yes, of course. So get in the cab, please.
Wait, what was that music?
Oh, it was some sort of British theme. I thought it would be. I thought it would be funny, sir.
I understand it. It's quite nice, but why was it the wedding music?
Oh. Well, funny you should say that, sir. I have much to tell you. Your first assignment is in.
Oh, good. Oh, I slipped on a banana. Oh, fuck. Shit.
So we see them both get into the car, and obviously the driver is at the front driving. Jonathan is in the back, and he sees that there's a paper on the side of the one of the other seats. You'll see there, sir, that we have your first case for you, your first news story.
Good. Lovely. Very good. News stories. God.
Yes.
Shit.
All about... we have a bit of a strange one here. Obviously, a public opinion piece, sir.
Well, I usually write the love horoscopes on the metro. this is a big change for me. Sorry, I'm still adjusting.
Well, this I say a public opinion. I more say public interest. It's about a man called Gerald. With that, we cut to We cut to Gerald A. Joe's character preparing for this meeting in Times Square.
Gerald, I've known you for 1 year, and this just doesn't seem right. Gerald!
Yes?
Every time I try to express exactly how I feel about Gerald, not you, my husband, I just feel like it doesn't feel right. Look, well, what I want to try is, can you just stand here? I'm going to read this to you, and I want to see how you feel about it. Gerald, I feel like I've known you for as long as I've been able to know things. I feel like you are everything that matters to me. And that fundamentally, without you, I wouldn't be Gerald anymore. Will you do me the pleasure of renewing our vows?
And will this be said before or after I, as the fake waiter, start choking on your wedding rings?
Okay, why are you choking on the wedding rings this time?
This was your plan. This is our plan. I was going to choke on the wedding rings. You were going to save me. And then the manager, who is also our friend Gerald, was going to come in and save you from trying to stop choking me.
Okay, but can you also please tell Gerald his Italian accent isn't working for the scene?
No, what are you meaning? I do not know.
Gerald, you're not Italian. You're Armenian. But come on, Gerald.
I am so Italian, authentic. Mamma mia.
Oh. Gerald, can you even spell pasta?
Pasta.
That's not spelling.
Oh.
Gerald, if we take, I think.
Sorry, do you mean.
You do me? Mean me?
Yeah.
No.
Do you mean yourself?
Why would I be talking to myself? Gerald A, if you take your seat, your husband should be coming shortly. Well, hopefully this works. And yes, I thought your piece was very nice.
We see Gerald, the other Gerald A, walk in. Oh, right, okay. I think I need to change now. Okay, right. Okay. Hi.
Isn't this nice? I've already got some soft drinks, bottomless. Only the finest for my husband.
Oh, God. This.
And don't worry. I know how you don't like waiting for things. You really want to just get down to the business of it. So I've already put in your order for you.
Yeah.
Just potato skins.
Gerald, you just don't listen. I don't like TGI Fridays. I don't like potato skins. Gerald, I mean, I don't know how to say this, but I think I want to change my name.
Why?
I think I want to change my name. I really hope you didn't ask me if you were going to ask me that, because the reason that I need to change my name is because I think we should get a divorce, Gerald.
At this point, other Gerald comes in, not having ever heard this, playing the waiter.
Hi guys, I've got your potato skin. Uh-oh.
Oh my god, what's the matter with him? What's the matter? What is the matter with him? Oh my god, what he's got, what's going on? Help him.
This was no, this is this was all part.
Help him. Oh my god. Oh my.
I was going to ask you to renew our vows. He's not actually choking. He's not choking. He's just, he's so, he decided the bit should be this time around. He chokes on the rings and he.
At this point we see Jonathan run in and sort of stumble and bumble and kind of start performing some sort of improvised Heimlich on Gerald, the choking one.
And it becomes clear he's not actually doing it. What he's just doing is slipping on a variety of bottomless soft drinks that have been spilled and just constantly grabbing him to try and stabilize himself.
And we then see the ring sort of fly out. Oh my god. Wow.
Yeah, thank you, but it's okay. This was an act. He wasn't actually choking. He doesn't even work here. Yeah, Gerald, great performance. It's fine. Can we get a moment?
Did it work? Are you both remarried again?
Okay, even.
Where's the?
You do know that if he says yes to renew the vows, that isn't the renewing of the vows.
We see the manager of TGI Friday come in, being like, okay, guys, you're going to have to leave. This is ridiculous. You've created a lot of chaos here today, and the children are crying. Everybody leave right now.
Okay, fine.
Just as they're leaving, one child pours another drink, causing everyone to fall over into a pile again.
Oh,
bloody kids!
We see the outside of we see Times Square. Obviously, it's busy. There's loads of people moving around, and we then see most of the characters there. With Gerald talking to Gerald A. Gerald, I just don't think that. I think I'm just gonna change my name, and then we can just. You know, I think this was just a mistake. I think we had some good times together, but I think now is the time to stop. I think I'm going to renew my name to Jeremy, I think. Okay? I need you to sign it. I need you to sign it.
Is that what's going to make you happy?
Yes.
If that's really what will make you happy, I'll sign it, but I just want you to understand that I meant it when I said that this was for life. I will.
What do you mean? What are you gonna do? Oh, shit.
I will never be with anyone else. I will wait for you until you're ready to come back.
Oh, this isn't fun. Why? Oh no.
I will sit and wait until the day.
No. Are you gonna sit right there? What, in front of TGI Fridays?
No, I'm gonna sit right there in front of the M&M store. Oh, God. Conveniently also where I work as an off copyright Iron Man. Just if anyone asks, remember my name's Steel Boy.
Suddenly Jonathan comes in. Oh, I'm so sorry. I thought your friend was the waiter was choking, and I'm so sorry about ruining your evening. We all got kicked out.
No, it's fine. It's my stupid husband. Ex-husband.
Not yet.
Oh, you're still here? I thought you crossed the fucking road.
I've got good hearing.
What are you doing speaking to this, what seems to be Iron Man?
Steel Boy.
Steel what?
Steel Boy.
Okay. Well,
or a titanium teen, if you want. I don't know.
I'm just, I like Titanium Teen sounds way cooler. I'm just
Thank you. I tried to convince him and he just kept saying, Steel Boy, Steel Boy, no, I'm Steel Boy.
Well, I'm so sorry to interrupt. I just wanted to come over here and apologize. And oh, shit, I've dropped my briefcase with all my papers and my boxes around.
Please let me help you. Let me help you.
Suddenly, as they're doing so, they both go to pick up a pack of strawberry lace sweets and somehow end up holding one of them by each of their teeth and meeting at the middle of it.
Oh, I'm so sorry. It's so stupid. I'm so sorry. Fuck.
No, it's okay. Hi, Mike.
So sorry. How did that happen?
Sorry, what's your name?
My name's Jonathan.
Hi, I'm Gerald. I'm not Gerald anymore. I'm now Jeremy. I'm Jeremy.
Oh, you say you used to be called Gerald?
Yes, yeah, Gerald, yeah.
Oh, it's funny, but you, oh, okay, well, never mind, because your name's Jeremy now. I guess you wouldn't be interested.
What? What do you mean?
Oh, you see, I've just come to the Big Apple to take a crunch out of the newspaper business, and I'm writing an article about the Gerald Con. That's happening. I guess do you have something to do with it? I guess not anymore, because your name's Jeremy.
Well, it hasn't gone through yet. I was tempted to go see what was happening. I mean, would you want to go with me?
Well, if you wouldn't mind, I'd love to ask some questions.
Sure. So, yeah.
So is Titanium Teen going to stop staring at us?
Titanium Teen is my ex-husband.
Oh. We cut across the road to we see Gerald A. dressed in, as Steel Boy, and next to him are two people billed as the Translucent Lady and the Thang. The Thang has a plaque around his neck saying it's globbering time.
We cut away, and we cut to Gerald, Tom's character, who's now Jeremy, his apartment, and we see that he is sitting down on the sofa with Jonathan, and they're going through loads of papers. Oh, so I'm so sorry about the papers. I'm so sorry.
It's okay. You keep dropping them everywhere. You know, it's fine. Let's just.
Yes, I'm sorry. Well, I wanted to ask you was why change your name? Why change it to Jeremy?
Well, I mean, so I tried to. My lawyer said that I couldn't get a divorce unless I had a name change, because my name was Gerald and my husband's name is Gerald, and when we married, I took his name and. So we sort of became the same person by law.
What?
And
ring, ring. What? Ring, ring.
Ring. Hello.
Hey, yeah, it's Jerry again.
Hi, your lawyer. Jerry. Yeah, your lawyer. Yeah, I remember my lawyer.
I got some bad news for you. I was looking at the laws again.
Yeah.
And the laws say that If you don't seal your new name with True Love's Kiss by Midnight, then you'll have to be sewn together with your ex-husband.
No, I'd have to be sewn together with Steel Boy.
We see Jerry is in this dark room with a fucking cauldron and potions and shit. And we see like reptilian minions around him.
who are all
just dancing around him, wearing a dark cloak with a hoodie on, and he's holding a staff.
Look, I've been consulting the oracles of New York law, and it's very clear that you don't obtain True Love's Kiss by Midnight, and it's now quarter to eight. You don't obtain it in the next 4 and a quarter hours, You will be sewn together with your ex-husband.
Oh, no.
Okay, bye. That's $1,000.
What?
Who was that?
Sorry, it was my lawyer. He said, I don't know, do you do much writing about law?
Both
in the L-A-W sense and the L-O-R-E sense.
No, I don't.
My lawyer, I mean, he's just saying that, I mean, you've probably heard of this one 1,000 times, I'm sure, when you're, you know, when you're writing your articles and stuff there. But he said that if I don't seal my divorce with if I don't seal my divorce with True Love's Kiss by midnight, I'll be sewn to my husband.
Well, that's a pretty strange.
When I say it like that, it almost seems ridiculous. But hey, that's lawyers for you, am I right?
It's a pretty strange metaphor. I don't understand it.
No, it's Jonathan. It's not a metaphor. This is my damnation.
Oh, Gerald, you're so funny. I could never be as funny as that, or as charming, or as nice. And well, I'm sorry, I'm speaking out of terms. I'm sorry.
No, it's fine. yeah. Well, I mean, it's just so nice that you're calling me charming, because I think, you know, the exact same way about you.
About who?
About you, Jonathan. Oh,
sorry, I've just dropped my bananas on the floor again. I'm so sorry. What did
you keep dropping your banana? How many bananas do you have in that briefcase?
I'm secretly importing British bananas into American soil.
What?
No, it's a I just like bananas. They're great with potassium and hey, if you've got diarrhea, they're great. They're great to eat.
Is that so?
Yes.
I never knew that, because you see, the thing is, I used to say to Gerald, my ex-husband, all the time, you know, like, oh, you've got such verbal diarrhea, you know, you just talk and talk, and you know, if I what I used to do is just sort of, funny enough, I just used to shove bananas down his mouth just to keep him quiet, you know. Didn't know that it helps it in that way as well.
To be honest, Gerald, I just wanted to say that I kind of like your real name, Gerald. I mean, of course your ex-husband is called Gerald, and his best friend and best man is called Gerald, and your lawyer is called, I heard over the phone, Jerry, or you know, Gerald, and you go to Gerald Con. I get it. There's a lot of Gerald's in your life, but I don't know. This is my opinion, but I don't think you should go on with your life thinking that that you wanted to be something different and change your name. I think you're a great Gerald. And you're one of a kind. You're not like everybody else. You're, you know, it's not just your name that defines you. Oh, just stick a banana in my mouth, right?
No, not at all. Sorry, it was just amazing that you could say that while slipping on so many bananas at the same time, you know?
Oh, Gerald, my pants have dropped. I'm so sorry.
Oh.
No. Wow. Oh, goodness, no. Not like that. Oh, no.
God.
The belt buckle wasn't on.
I don't think I'm Jonathan.
Oh god, oh fuck.
Suddenly one of the many other Geralds walks past. Oh, is that a banana in his pants?
No, I think it actually is.
Oh, okay.
What are you doing here?
I'm Gerald. I was the best man at the wedding.
We cut to a couple of hours later.
We see on the clock it's just gone 25 to midnight.
We see Gerald and Jonathan just standing before the gates of Gerald Con, which is in a spectacular palace. Cinderella-like-esque, and everybody is
guns
and in sharp suits, and there's like a pumping carriage in the corner.
And there are two guards with big spears. And you keep seeing people kind of, they speak to people and they say something and they walk in, they say something and then they walk in. And eventually, as Gerald and Jonathan get to the front of the line, the guards speak to them.
Gerald?
Yes, I'm Gerald.
Strange. You're not passing the Gerald scanner. Well, sorry, no, let's just try your friend. Gerald?
Yes, Gerald.
No, I'm talking to your friend, Gerald.
Well, I'm not Gerald, no, but I'm a reporter. I've got a reporter pass.
Okay, in that case, in you.
Thank you. And I want my friend to come with me too. Only if we hold hands.
What?
I don't know. We've never had two non-Geralds at GeraldCon before.
But if one person is holding the hands of another person who's a reporter, it means that they're the same person.
We can also
pull under New York law. That's field. Correct. Yes.
Yes. Oh, God.
But you have to remain holding hands for the entire evening.
What will happen to me?
You'll be turned back into a mouse.
We cut to Gerald and Jonathan dancing together in the ballroom, and we see in the distance, we see like in the lawyer's office, we see Jerry the lawyer like touching his crystal ball. And dressing him both.
My God, I never realized it, but it turns out that true love can defeat even New York law.
We cut to the ballroom, and we see them dancing. Gerald, I just want to say, I'm sorry for holding your hand for the entire night. My hand was so sweaty, and I'm so sorry.
But hey, you don't need to apologize. I know that we just did it. You did it to just get past the force field.
Yeah.
But I kind of think we should do it, you know, when we get out of here as well.
We should do it. We should do what? We should do
it. We see on the wall the big Gerald kiss cam. As a cameraman zooms in on Jeremy and Jonathan.
We also hear a few kiss. People see that he's a reporter, not called Gerald. So people start hissing.
But then he shows his press pass. Then he shows his news. Look, I'm a reporter. I'm a reporter.
Press.
Kiss. Gerald, I just want to say, you had me at hello.
Oh, come here, you.
Just as they lean in for a kiss, we see in the corner of the room other Gerald A being pulled away by two cops dressed as Mickey Mouse, holding a cease and desist letter. And they kiss. But happily ever after. And that's the show.
The credits roll, and that's the show.
Yeah.
I was wondering where that was going to go when we had about seven Geralds, and then I wasn't expecting the magic, but I kind of enjoyed it.
Good show. Post-credit sequence.
What? We cut to 500 years later, and outside the M&M store. There's a rusted steel boy, so he's completely sort of rusted and brown, and you see a parent holding a small child's hand, and the child goes, "Mama, what's that there?"
"Well, son, nobody knows, but they say that if you get too close, you choke on a potato skin." Get too close, Jimmy. Don't get too close.
to be continued? Question mark. That's the show. Or is it?
We cut away to the back in London, and we see a Ray Winston type in like what looks like a room of people handling drugs, but they're actually just handling bananas.
Or is it the final scene? We cut to after the credits, and we see Nock Fury with two eye patches come in and say, Steel Boy, I want you to join the Avengers initiative.
Just then, Nock Fury with his two eye patches falls down an open manhole cover he didn't see.
And that's the show.
Wow.
I'm joking. Wow.
They said it couldn't be done.
And yet here we are.
But hey, look, I feel like, you know what? That was as good as any big budget Holly weird movie I've ever seen. If I wanted to kind of get the fun of that, but like not as a movie, as like something kind of bite-sized, that I could enjoy on the move without looking at it. Tom, is there anywhere I could get Boat Club in that style?
You're telling me, Joe. I'll tell you what you could do, buddy.
I'm asking you.
Oh, you're asking me, Joe. I'll tell you what you could do. You could go on to wherever you get your podcast and you could download or stream your very own Boat Club episode of choice. There are jingles. It sounds nice in your ear holes. And there's nothing better than when we come on inside your ears. Come on.
What? And Tom, where can we find you online if we want to find you?
You can find me at Tom Pullen Graham on Instagram. You can find me at Tom Pullen Tweets on Twitter. And you can find me at at Boat Club Improv, where we are still trying to get a multitude of people onto Fortnite. So please join the cause.
And John.
Oh,
John.
Oh, my God. Oh, guys, there's a fire in here.
It's okay. That's just my DVD of Backdraft playing. The movie Backdraft. Remember that?
Oh, I thought that fire over there was coming from my phone where I just had John's tweets.
You guys better be careful, because these tweets are coming at you red hot like a chili pepper. Better get the aloe vera, because your boy's coming at you.
Oh, get me the yogurt, Poppy.
You better put some lemon and some lime on that.
Guys, I handled a phone that had some of John's tweets on it, and now I've got to put aloe vera over both hands.
Is this a volcanic eruption? No, it's my fiery tweets. You can find all those tweets and your favorite tweets, including the Pillsbury fuckboy, at what's my Twitter handle?
At John One Boardman.
John Boardman.
O-N-E-B-O-A-R-D-M-A-N. John, go write some more tweets. I know you're watching this.
Yeah. And hey, John.
Yeah.
If you're watching this, I'm talking to future John.
Okay.
Sorry, not to get you confused with other John. But hey.
This is like future Joe John, over again.
I'd like to thank John, who's here today, for liking my latest tweet. Which you can find at Nocho Ranchka. That's NotjoeRanchka. And you can find me for all your spicy hot takes about the new Matrix film. Is Keanu looking hot in it? Go onto my Twitter to find out.
Who? I thought John Wick was in that movie.
No. But hey, boys. Just to end, I think that instead of doing a recipe, we should end by all singing the end credits theme to the movie we just saw.
D-I-V-O-R-C-E. D-I-V-O-R-C-E.
D-I-V-O-R-C-E.
D-I-V-O-R-C-E. It spells divorce, Tom. D-I-V-O-R-C-E.
Well, we say around here, we spell divorce D-I-V-O-R-C-E. But down there in New York, it turns out they spell it G-E-R-A-L-D. E-I-V-O-R-C-E.
Coming in the first time. Coming in the first time. That's right. Gerald. Gerald, I was about the Gerald and the wizard. The wizard lawyer. Remember him? Yeah, that's the thing. Gerald. Bye, 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 bye.